this is a real challenging show. And, you know, if you're thinking that this is not, it's, you're very, very wrong. It's very, very challenging. And I'll never look at something the same thinking, oh, that's easy, I can go do that. I know better now.
How are y'all?
We're good, how are you?
That first day, I thought I brought warm clothes. I was wrong. that first day, I knew right then that, because I'm that person, if my feet get cold, I just want to go. I want to go sit in the truck. I'm done until my feet warm up. I figured out right then that I'm going to have to do things a little bit differently. In fact, I started putting grocery bags over my feet so that my feet would not get wet. But that first day, it set the scene for, okay, you're going to have to do things way different than what you thought you were going to come up here and do, because it is cold. This is real.
Hey, you want to bring them this direction?
Wherever you go is where we go with them.
You know, I said from the very beginning I was handy with a rope. I proved that in the roping challenge in the pasture. I drew a bad cow at the end. I couldn't get to her fast enough. I excelled in that, which proved what I said from the beginning. I'm handy with a rope. I wish I would have gotten to show that more.
Oh, she got him right here. She got him half head around the horns, getting stopped. She got him.
Brianna
moves on.
Everything else, I'm happy with the way I performed, the way my horse performed. I'm not going to fault myself at all, except for the fence post.
Is there anybody here that right off the bat knows what they want to do?
Yeah, I want to throw hay.
You want to throw hay? What do you
Put
want?
Me on the wood.
You on the wood?
Yeah. I'll fix the fence.
If I went back and did it again, yeah, I would definitely choose to do something different. You know, I went into that thinking I got this. This is easy, and it was way more. I bit off a whole lot more than what I thought I was biting off. You know, that was a tough challenge. And I mean, I did the best I could with it, but that little hammer just wasn't cutting it.
I think she got her finger pretty good there.
I didn't know it was hurt until I started seeing blood. So it just the adrenaline. I was going. I wanted to get through it, and I wanted to make my team elevate. So.
Well, what's the word?
I got 15 stitches and the end of my finger's crushed.
Oh.
So I've had several follow-ups. It's still, they want to amputate the end of my finger. And I'm holding on to the end of my finger. I don't want them to amputate it just yet. The bone was so damaged, it did not mend. So the end of my finger is displaced, and it's not real pretty, but it only hurts when it gets cold, and it's not on my rope in hand, so I'm holding on to it as long as I can.
Today, that fence wasn't fixed.
I mean, I was doing what I thought I could do to get it done.
You did. I got no question about you saying, no question about how much grit you got, and you are one gutsy competitor. But you're done here.
I do believe I let my team down. I didn't complete that challenge to the standard that was asked for. So I did not complete my job. You know, and injury aside, bottom line, I didn't do my part. I hated to leave on the terms that I did, but had everybody's respect when I left. And that was an emotional moment for me, because knowing that, you know, I got injured and I was leaving. Although with that being said, with the injury I sustained, I don't think I could have continued, although I would have tried, don't get me wrong. you know, but it was an emotional moment, and I'm glad everybody was so supportive when I did leave. And that was really emotional for me, for the support the contestants gave me when I left. I did make some really good friends. We all have stayed in contact. We have a group message, actually, and we all share each other's shenanigans through life. So it's been really good to keep in contact. We've made some really good friendships along the way. You know, I think that Stephen Heitman, I think he's a hand. I think he's a really, really good horseman. I think Buck Faust, excellent horseman, he's a hand. And Coy, and I don't want to butcher his last name. Jamon was excellent with a rope. He proved that a couple different times. That's really the way I feel about it. I'm not rooting for anybody in particular, but luck is going to come into play. You've got to go have several good days, and you've got to stand out. So since the show stopped filming, I've been super busy. We've been putting on ropings like crazy. We've had several a weekend, actually, and I've been rodeoing and continuing on with life, selling consignment horses. It's been crazy, crazy busy. The only thing I can say to all the viewers that are watching is these challenges, they are real. And if you don't believe that with the busted finger, you know, That was not a fake deal. That was real. It sustained real follow-up appointments. This is a real challenging show, and you know, if you're thinking that this is not, you're very, very wrong. It's very, very challenging, and I'll never look at something the same thinking, oh, that's easy, I can go do that. I know better now.